sideline trout line, sitting on a pipeline, waiting for the sun to shine. Snap beans, red beans, cornbread, and mustard greens, that's how we live and it sure feels fine. Well, you can't change us, that's the way we know. Cajun people live like they did long ago. So join the fun, live off the land, 'cause there ain't nothing better than a Louisiana man. Tightline, trapline, sitting on a pipeline, waiting for the sun to shine. Snap beans, red beans, cornbread, mustard greens, that's how we live, and it sure feels fine.
Hey everybody, welcome to Cajun Living and Cooking. My name's Rodney Dupree and today we got a really cool show for y'all. We're out at the Poche Plantation's third annual Arts and Crafts Show. It's in Convent, Louisiana. We're on the River Road, we're right by the levee. Got the awesome plantation behind us. Got some really cool stuff going on today. We got dancers, we got a food cook-off, we've got beauty queens, we've got all kind of neat stuff going on. Craft booths galore. It's going to be really, really fun and a bunch of good food. So y'all hang on. Cajun Living and Cooking's fixing to start right about now. All right, y'all, we made it over to the Jambalaya Cooks. This first cook, let's get his name and where he's from.
Bailey Richard from Paulina.
Now, you cooked in this before.
Yes, last year.
And so you got some redemption to do. You want to win first this year.
Oh, yeah, because last year, actually, my granny won first and my papa got second last year.
Oh.
So,
here
you go.
You was telling me you was telling me your grandpa taught you how to cook.
Yeah.
So you want to beat him this year.
Oh, yeah.
All right, man. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
All right, y'all, got another cook. Let's get his name and where he's from.
My name's Marty Michel. We're from Paulina, Louisiana.
Now, you cooked in this last year.
Yes, sir. We did.
And yeah. You come out second.
Came out second last year. I hate to say it, but my wife beat me.
Oh, that's how it goes sometimes. So you shooting for first to beat her this year.
Oh, hell yeah.
And
yeah.
You got to beat your grandson, too.
I got to beat everybody here.
Gotcha.
I'm working on it.
You working on a first place spot?
Yes, sir.
All right. Well, good luck to you.
Thank you.
All right, y'all. I got another cook. Let's get her name and where she's from.
Hi, my name is Cheryl Michel, and I'm from Paulina, Louisiana. And this is my second go-round. I placed first last year.
She was the winner last year, y'all. So you looking to get two in a row?
That would be nice. That would be nice. And also, I would like to thank Poche Plantation for putting this on and helping the community out.
Well, I'm going to tell you good luck and hopefully two-time it.
Well, thank you so much.
All right, y'all, made it over to another cook. Let's get his name and where he's from.
Larry Martin from Laplace, Louisiana.
Now, have you cooked in the Poche Plantation cook-off before?
First time, sir.
First time, but you've cooked mini pots several times.
Yes, sir.
Well, what's your secret to a good jambalaya?
My really main secret is not only a lots of love in the pocket.
Yeah.
But there's a rocket in my pocket.
Oh, a rocket.
And it's Uncle Larry's seasoning.
Well,
how
ain't
about
that something? You can't cook jambalaya without that.
That's correct.
Well, I'm going to wish you good luck and hope you win it all.
It always kicks it up a notch.
All right, y'all, here we are at Poche Plantation, and who I run across? My nanny and my dad. They got a booth here, and they do some really cool stuff, y'all. Amazing. For instance, some of this stuff that she paints is priceless. Tell us a little bit about this piece.
Well, I just love this place. That's the Our Lady of Blind River on the river. It's been there for years. But I also do...
As you can see, or you can't see, you only got a 10 by 10 space, and they got so much neat stuff. Some of the stuff hides some of the even better stuff. Every piece you pick up is really nice. The painting she does is amazing, and Daddy also makes some different things, like, yeah. What you got, what do you call this piece?
This is soccer net net here. This is when you're really hogging them in, and you ain't got time to tangle up your net. This don't tangle up really, the monofilament. And I make paddles.
And that's from Cypress.
Oh, yeah.
Out of the swamp.
I'm the one retrieving that, and she's doing most of the painting.
Awesome. Now, how can people get in touch with you? What phone number you got for people to get in touch with you?
Well, I'd like them to call 985-320-9922. That's my cell. I can get you anytime. Leave a message. But we also have 225-788-8110, and that's Rodney. So either one of us, call us. We'll do something for you. We got plenty of cypress.
Really awesome stuff, y'all. Really awesome art. Well, one-of-a-kind pieces of wood with one-of-a-kind paintings on them. So give them a call. All right, y'all, made it over to another booth with some awesome treats and sweets. Let's get her name and where she's from.
Hi, my name's Leslie Jones, and I'm from Houma, Louisiana.
Now, do you have a shop or you do this out of your home?
I do it out of my home, yes.
You have some really unique items here. Now, this is your recipes or family recipes? Or?
It's recipes that I've found, and then I tweaked it to something that I liked. So I started with the base, and then I turned it into my own.
Do you get any help cooking all this up?
No.
It's you.
It's all me.
Awesome, awesome. Yep. Now, how can people get in touch with you?
They can find us on Facebook, Mystique Creations, or they can give us a call, 985-381-9893.
There it is, y'all. Sweets. Good, good sweets. All right, y'all, this is just some other good fun happening here at Poche Plantation. A bunch of acoustical jammers sitting around. I guess half of them know each other, the other half don't, or they probably played together before. They're going to do us a song right here, and that's something else at Poche, y'all. Y'all can bring your guitar out, eat some good food, listen to some good music, and do some jamming. So they're going to do a song right here for us. Let's see what they got. Y'all, we just had the judging of the mini pots, and these are the judges here. Let's get their names and where they're from.
Natalie Chabot from Letcher, Louisiana.
Brandy Woodman, Galvez.
Stuart Woodman, Galvez.
Craig Porsche, Letcher.
Deepak Sandy, New Orleans.
John Happus Reitinger, Prairieville.
Stu Barish, New Orleans.
Hey, I'm Ann Cutler from New Orleans.
Well, was it stiff competition or what? Well, how was it?
It was stiff competition. I felt like there was one clear winner, personally, that I really liked. And I know the fellow Judge Deepak, who I brought along with me, agreed as well. I don't know about the other judges.
Gotcha. Was it tight, though? I mean, were they all close?
Yeah, they were all pretty close.
Too tight, in my opinion, too tight. And the other three fell a little bit behind, but they were all excellent.
Yeah.
Good, good. None of them were just corroted with salt or burn or anything.
Oh, no, not
I'd
at
take
all.
Anyone. We're still judging.
We're still eating them.
Absolutely.
There it is, y'all. Stiff competition. We're going to have a winner here soon.
Market has everything you need when you're going to the camp, tailgating, or planning dinner. We make our own cracklings, beef jerky, hog head cheese, and sausage right here in the store. We also process deer and hogs. Junior's Meat Market has an abundance of groceries and frozen items, which include crab cakes, fried oysters, tilapia, and more. We have daily meat specials, and we cook plate lunches every other weekend. Stop by Junior's Meat Market today and bring home dinner. Lamar Dixon Expo Center, the crown jewel of Ascension Parish, supporting community development and charitable organizations. The center offers a wide variety of activities, such as outside show arenas, fully equipped barns, a newly renovated 4-H building, an Acadian-style chapel, RV parking with bathhouses, and large and small banquet rooms, just to name a few. Located in Gonzales and surrounded by hotels, restaurants, and great shopping venues. Come enjoy what Lamar Dixon Expo Center has to offer. Dreams Come True of Louisiana is a nonprofit organization that grants dreams to Louisiana children between ages 3 and 18 with a life-threatening illness. Dreams Come True was founded in 1982 by seven families in Denham Springs with a goal of providing dreams to children. All funding was initially provided by those families. Dreams Come True is proud to have one paid employee and provides dreams throughout the state of Louisiana. Dreams Come True provides an average of 65 to 70 dreams per year. Visit our website for more information, dctofla.com.
All right, y'all, we made it up in one of the food booths. It's Blue Runner's booth and Uncle Larry's seasoning booth. And that's a mighty big pot of jambalaya y'all got there.
Yes, sir. That's 100 pounds of jambalaya, yeah.
Wow. Y'all been moving some out of here.
Oh, yeah, quite a bit, actually. It's starting to pick up. It's right about lunchtime, and it's moving pretty good, yeah.
That's need a Blue Runner to be part of this with Larry. They always seem to go synonymous together.
Oh, absolutely. We got their red bean gumbo, of course, Blue Runner. Yeah, uh-huh. That always sells pretty well around this area. It's excellent.
You got some good help right here, too.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You got a nice little chain going.
Now, y'all think y'all going to sell this whole pot today?
We hope so. Gotcha. We'll probably get rid
that's
of a good
lot
bit
of jambalaya.
Oh, yeah,
there.
That's a whole lot.
We
got
to cook another one tomorrow.
Yeah, we got another one coming up. So.
All right. That's what it is, y'all. At Poche Plantation, real good food.
One of the purposes, one of the things that we do with your $5 that you paid to get in here is to help out various causes and people that need help. I had a good talk with this young man here. This is Clint Thompson. And what happened to Clint? Clint was caught in the tornado. It blew him. It just blew him out and up and down. 30 days later, a month, an entire month, he woke up later in the hospital. His faithful wife was by his side. They told me some stirring things. She talked to him while he was in a coma. He was in a 30-day coma. She talked to him. He couldn't hear her, but she asked him certain questions and pushed through. And she asked him, do you want to fight? And, of course, he mumbled or whatever he did. He let her know that he wanted to fight. And here he is with us today, and part of this is going to go to help Clint Thompson. Let's bring out, there's another gentleman, Peters.
I don't know where he's at.
We can't find him.
He's here somewhere, but he was in a coma for several months and had that brain surgery.
All right, y'all, we're out here at Poche Plantation for the third annual Arts and Crafts Show. And we're going to show y'all why the money is raised and where the money's going around here. Let these two guys introduce themselves to you. Let me get your name and where you're from.
My name's Luke Peters, and I'm from Bonifay, Florida.
William Thompson, I'm from Grayson, Louisiana.
All right, y'all, the tornado that came through here this past year devastated this area, and both of these guys were affected by this, and both were knocked unconscious in the tornado and flipping around and being thrown through the air, but don't remember a thing. Don't remember a single thing.
No, sir, I don't even remember the...
No, sir, I don't.
And y'all, Poche Plantation has come together with all these people here and raising money for these folks to be able to go on and have a great life. And number one, I want to thank Poche Plantation. And number two, I want to thank y'all for coming out here. And y'all continue on strong, fellas. Very strong. And thank y'all. Thank y'all. All right, y'all, we backstage with Yvonne's Dancers. And I'm going to tell you what, these girls can really dance. They fixing to get out here and do some dancing. Now, all y'all been having fun out here today?
Yes!
All right. That tells you right there they fixing to have some serious fun. Now, how many songs y'all going to be doing? Two, three, one?
Three!
All right. All right. Eight?
Oh.
Well, there it is right there, y'all. This is fixing to be some fun. I'm going to wish y'all all good luck, and y'all have a good time. Thank y'all. Hydraulic Fabrication and Repair, located in Santa Maria, Louisiana, has been in the repair business for over 37 years, specializing in chrome rod, hydraulic tubing, and new cylinders. The benefit of a fully stocked warehouse of seals and chrome rods puts you back in operation, in most cases, in 3 days or less. We make hydraulic hoses and manufacture cylinders, offering 24-hour service and also pickup and delivery. Give Hydraulic Fabrication and Repair the opportunity to help your business. And remember,
we can't fix it, it ain't broke!
Galvez Hardware and Outdoor Cooking is two unique stores in one. The hardware department has everything you need to fix stuff right. The outdoor cooking section cannot be beaten. We have all the latest and greatest gadgets on the market. But also, we keep a large stock of the tried and tested cookware we've all come to love over the years. Coffee and biscuits every morning during the week, cooking demos on Saturdays, and customer service that will help you get the job done. RP Custom Trailers and Service is a fully stocked store for RV parts and accessories with essentials such as tank treatments, hoses, lenses, vents, power cords, cleaning supplies, and everything else your camper may need. Known for customized living quarters and horse trailers for over 18 years. We now specialize in RV insurance work. Talk to Ryan about how to prevent blowouts, and oh yes, that leaky vinyl or rubber roof can be inspected and repaired also. Call or come by and see it all at RP Custom Trailers. Miss D's Sweet Sensations is a wholesale sweet shop located in Santa Maria, Louisiana. The business is locally owned and operated by Diane Bro, now with 12 delicious varieties to choose from. You can find Mrs. D's Sweet Sensations in all of your local supermarkets and convenience stores. Made fresh daily by 6 full-time employees, right here in Ascension Parish. Hey, store owners, restaurants, and caterers, if you're not selling Mrs. D's Sweet Sensations, you're not selling the best product on the market.
Y'all, we made it in one of the booths, and the line's all around, y'all. The place is packed with people here at Poche Plantation, and we got in the booth, and hope we're not in the way over here. What you making there? That's tornado fries?
Yes.
Wow, that's a good bit.
You
get the fries, and then they got the shrimp basket. And what's the other one? The tenders? Is that the chicken tenders or fish?
No.
That's fish?
And shrimp.
All right, boy, them fries look good. And look at the people, y'all. They steadily pumping them out. Everybody's coming up to get some food. You got the girls working back here. You got all the fryers working in the back. It's really good stuff at Poche Plantation, y'all. Come on out and eat some good fried fair food. All right, y'all, we made it into another booth. It's Big Will and the Warden. Big Will and the Warden. They got it going on, y'all. They got some really nice stuff. Stuff like this seafood platter right here. Look at this. Soft shell crab, fish, fries, all the stuff you really want. Look, and the secret ingredient on there with the shrimp. Now look at this one. We give her a shot of that. Look at there. They look as fast as they can get them. They're going out of here. That looked like a good Philly cheesesteak is what that looked like. I see them on the grill over here, if you can see. Got stuff going on the grill, pulling the seafood platters off. Y'all, the lines around the building, and they're keeping up with it really, really well. Things are flying out of here. More chicken and coming up, the soft shell crabs. They got a good crew going, got the grill going. Got my fry man back here. He can't even turn around to see the crowd coming. He is steadily frying back here. You got it down to a science, though. You got it. Y'all, that's what you get out here at Poche Plantation. Good food, fast food. And it's great.
Oh boy. Oh boy.
And the drum roll.
Are you still gonna win?
I don't know now.
Oh boy. I know, I'm just taking time because I want you to sweat a little bit. Okay, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go down, I'm gonna start with letter E and work backwards. Letter E and backwards, okay? So E is gonna be number two. D is number four. C is number three. So that means we've got a one and a five left. This is gonna change it. B, number one. Five for number A, for letter A, excuse me. So Larry said he was gonna win, and the man's a soothsayer. Larry wins, Wendy second, tied for third, and fourth. So the tiebreaker. Alright. So the tiebreaker is gonna be right there. We got two fives for Cheryl. No fives there. It looks like Cheryl has got it. Am I correct?
Cheryl in third.
Cheryl in third. There you go. Marty and then Bailey.
All right, y'all, I got the winner right here, Mr. Larry Martin. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
You had some...
Yes, sir.
...for the big accomplishment you got out here today and whipping all their...
Who owns this fabulous place.
Mark Anderson.
And he has a nice foundation for the tornado victims of this parish that would happen, and that's why I'm here. And... Larry Roussel for giving me the seasoning to win this. And I don't know, it's me and my wife, we went neck and neck, but I got the winner.
You got the golden cup. You gonna put something in there and drink it?
Probably.
Might
so.
Have to, huh?
Yes,
might
sir.
Have to.
Yes, sir.
Here it is, y'all. Poche Plantation Jambalaya Cook-Off, which is funding the tornado victims, and it takes people like this coming out, cooking off to raise money for this. So, congratulations.
And I would welcome anybody to come out next year. Please come out and enjoy this festival. We have plenty activities and arts and crafts, and it's a beautiful place.
Congratulations again.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. All right, y'all, we made it into Poche Plantation. And you don't understand how old these houses are back from the day here on the River Road. The ceilings are 12 foot tall. The doors are humongous, you know. It's unlike anything that we live in today, like some of these chairs. I'd be scared to sit in some of these chairs like this. For instance, some of these old unique books from the time, you know. Here's another old cool chair. And even this fancy couch right here, you know, that's got to date back to the 1800s at least, you know. And some of the unique things you see in here, for instance, the writer's desk. I'm going to come back to that. But the fireplace goes through to the other wall. So you had a fireplace on one side, but it would warm both sides of the house. Really, really unique. The old writer's desk. It's where Thomas Edison and the like back in the day used to sit down. You know, that they didn't have a computer. They didn't have an iPad. They sit down and actually took the ink pen and dipped it in the ink with the feather and wrote on it. So this is just one room in here. There's an upstairs. There's all kind of neat things to see in here. So when you come to Poche Plantation, be expected to see something that you've never seen before, or something you've only seen in books or seen on TV. This is really unique, so you got to come check it out. Day out at Poche Plantation, as she pans around and shows you the crowd that's out. I want to tell you, we had a blast out here. This is just the first day of Saturday, and we met some really good people. We tasted some good food. We've been through the plantation itself, met some good vendors, had a good time hanging out here. Really, really fun. I'm gonna tell y'all what, it's something to come out here with this cool weather snap. Usually hits around October. It's really, really great to come out here and have a good time. And I want to tell y'all to check us out on Facebook. And thank y'all for watching Cajun Living and Cooking.